Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Minnesota Twins franchise series here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. Now, the Twins have started their season at 4-2, and now they get to come home for their home opener at Target Field against the Kansas City Royals, opening up the home schedule, sending Ricky Nolasco to the mound. He's 0-1 with, it didn't go well the first time, 7.2 ERA. Looking to better that mark today against Danny Duffy, who is 1-0, had a successful first start. So let's see if that trend continues for both these pitchers. However, he picked up Kansas City's only win as they're 1-5, so something's got to give today. Looks like a pretty packed house here for the opener at Target Field. Well, to see if that continues all year long. That has not been the case in recent years as the Twins have struggled to keep afloat. And while they haven't even been close to 500 in the last few years. So, yeah, attendance has suffered. But maybe, just maybe, they can keep people interested this season. And, well, be respectable. We'll have to see. Ricky Nolasco on the mound. And he's going to get strike three on the slider to get out of the first inning. And there you go. Despite having one man on, he's able to get out of that. Danny Santana leading off for the Twins with a hit to center field. So Santana's on, and we'll have to see how they play this with the leadoff hitter on and a chance to either bunt him over or let Brian Dozier swing away. They're going to try to bunt, and he pops it up, but it does at least get to the ground where it will be a successful sacrifice. Looked a little iffy at first. So this sets up Joe Mauer with one out and a runner on. Joe Mauer in real life lately has been an RBI machine, as he has really come on strong, and he does the same here. Is he safe? Yes! Santana slides around the tag, and it's 1-0 Twins on the Joe Mauer RBI single. Look at it again here from the wide cam right up the middle, and Santana is not hesitating, coming around third, and he has a nice slide effort here to get around a potential tag, and he's safe. 1-0 Twins. In the first, we go to the top of the second now, and Nolasco is going to give up a base hit. Got runners at first and second, and the Royals have a threat going right here in the top of the second inning. Nolasco's got to try to settle down and get out of this thing. 2-2 with two outs, and he will get a fly ball. Left center field, tracking it is Arcia. He will indeed get there to make the catch, and the inning is over. The Royals strand a couple runners and have nothing to show for it. Fourth inning now, 3-2 count. This is going to be a base hit to right. One run will score. Torrey Hunter's throw gets the next runner. So one scores, but they get a little greedy trying to get the go-ahead run. Suzuki applies the tag, and he is out, well, by quite a distance, actually. Hunter puts this throw right where it needs to be on one hop, and yep, you're gone. So at least they cut down one run, and it is a tie ball game. Bottom of the fourth, Kenny Vargas is going to hit that to right field, but it's caught. Danny Duffy's actually settled into quite a groove right now, as he's only given up two hits, and those were early on. So we are now in the top of the fifth with Nolasco getting a strikeout. He's going to get out of the inning. We're actually getting quite a solid start out of Ricky today, much better than his first outing. Into the top of the sixth now. Oh, that's going to be ball four on the slider. Wouldn't bite on it. That's going to load the bases, so a big-time jam with two outs. He works 1-2 count, and strike three on the splitter. Gets him swinging, so he leaves the bases loaded. Kansas City has stranded a lot of runners so far. Bottom of the sixth, Danny Santana taking off, and he will steal second base, getting himself into scoring position, trying to be that go-ahead run. So using Danny Santana's speed right there. 3-2 with two outs. Torrey Hunter to the gap in right center, and it's down for a hit. He cut down a run with his throw from right field before. Now he's going to drive one in with his bat. Torrey Hunter makes it 2-1 Twins. All right, big clutch hit right there. After Santana got into scoring position, Hunter brings him home with this hit right here. You see the replay. Nice job getting it done with the RBI. So now we move on to the top of the eighth. Still 2-1. 0-2 count. This is going to be a ground ball. Could it be a double play? Gets them out of the inning. They had two runners on, but just like that, the Twins get out of it. double play ends the inning. We go to the ninth, and we call on Glenn Perkins to try to get his third save of the young season. All right, the hometown boy. We'll be facing Kendrys Morales, who was a Twin for just a minute last year. Yeah, had a little stint here. Signed as a free agent and then traded away. But with two outs in the ninth, you got to be kidding me. It clears the fence. Blown save for Glenn Perkins and a collective groan from the faithful here at Target Field, the former Twin. It's kind of funny calling him that because he wasn't here that long. Kendrys Morales does in the Twins with this swing, at least for right now, as he ties the ball game at two. We're going to play into the bottom of the ninth. Trevor Plouffe is going to hit this to center field. It's got some carry. It's going to be off the base of the fence. He's hustling for second. Trevor Plouffe, lead off double in the bottom of the ninth, and he is your potential winning run, and he is jacked about that. Look at that, trying to get his teammates going. Let's go. Bring me home. As he makes solid contact, just goes with this and drives it to the opposite field alley. And like I said, he is pumped. Let's go. Let's win this game. Let's get the walk-off in the ninth. Kennys Vargas is up. And he is going to single the center field. That could be it. Runner coming around third. Trevor Plouffe will score. And the Twins win the home opener. They win the home opener in dramatic fashion. 3-2 in the bottom of the ninth. Blown save for Glenn Perkins, but then the Twins bail him out, and he actually gets the win in the ninth as they walk off. Kennys Vargas comes through with the big hit that will end the ball game. So the Royals still have only won one game on the young season, and they'll have to wait for tomorrow to get a chance at number two because the Twins walk off on this one. Your player of the game is going to go to Danny Santana as he had three hits in this game and a stolen base, scored two runs, was a catalyst for the Twins. So they get the record to 5-2. Glenn Perkins blows a save but gets a win. It's funny how baseball works sometimes. They split the next two games of Kansas City, so they win the series 2-1. And we'll take a 6-3 record into the next series against the Cleveland Indians. So Cleveland is in town for a 3-game set here. Twins will wear their throwbacks as well. They usually wear these. I guess they don't have a specific day where they used to wear them on like Saturday games or something like that. But they wore them the other day when I saw them. Oh, that ball hits the second base bag. Santana. No, they say safe. But hold on a second. Paul Molitor, well, whoever that's supposed to be, isn't so sure about it. He's coming out of the dugout and they're going to wait and see. Are they going to challenge this? We should have just enough time to peek at a replay here. And, oh, I think he's out. I think that throw beats him. We need to challenge this. Definitely worth the official look. So Molly's going to say, go ahead. Well, he gets the thumbs up from the dugout. So Molitor's going to say, go ahead and review this. He officially tells the umpire, we want to take a look. We want to challenge. So here they go. They got to go get the headsets and figure this out. Let's see another look at this. In Maurer's glove before he's at the bag. They're going to overturn this, I am pretty certain. Just a formality now. They're going to go ahead, talk it over, get word. And what are they going to call? He is indeed out. So that is a good challenge and my first overturned challenge here with the Twins. So good job getting that one correct and getting out of that situation here. But we got runners at second and third, already down 1-0 in this inning. And well, here come two more runs to the plate, making it 3-0 Indians. That throw probably should have gone to second base to keep that runner at first. Kind of poor baseball on our part. So down 3-0 in the bottom of the third now. We've got runners at the corners, and Torrey Hunter coming through again. This is going to be a gapper, and it's going to one hop the fence. Two runs will score on this play, cutting the Indians' lead to 3-2. So Torrey Hunter again picking up RBIs and swinging a pretty decent bat here. His average at this point, I think, was only around 200, but he is coming through with a couple clutch hits, as you see right there. So they get on the board. They cut this down to just a 3-2 deficit. Cleveland scores another. It's 4-2 in the sixth. When Joe Mauer comes up, and holy smokes, Mauer got a hold of that, and it is gone. Wow, he hit that a long way to right center field. Joe Mauer, solo homer, makes this game a 4-3 ball game, as they're now trailing just one run. The fans get to see some fireworks as Joe Mauer takes it out of the ballpark and he pulled it. How often does that happen? But a very nice swing right there, and he takes it out of the ballpark. Now, I said that Mauer is hitting really well in real life, and that is true. But the one thing he hasn't been doing is hitting home runs. Maybe that'll come too. Trevor Plouffe is going to hit this one in the ninth inning, try to make a rally. They throw him out. No, he can't handle it at first base. He cannot handle the throw at first base, and Trevor Plouffe is safe. You can't be giving up outs when you're trying to put away a team in the ninth. Well, they've got one out, though, and this is Arcia, and he is going to take it deep. Oh, no, it didn't. He did. Walk-off homer, Oswaldo Arcia, and the game is over. The Twins win in walk-off fashion again, this time with the long ball. Oh, man, the error just kills him here, because instead of this tying the game, it wins it. Arcia goes deep. The Twins win, and they get to celebrate at home plate with the walk-off. Oh, some dramatics at Target Field to start the season, as they've had a walk-off here in two occasions in just a handful of games played. So we got to see this again. Gets good swing on this, and it goes the opposite field. And, you know, it's no cheap shot hitting into the bullpens out there. This ballpark, I don't know. I mean, it's not like you can't hit home runs in it, but it often plays pretty big. But there you go, into the bullpens, and it's a game winner. And as he gets his interview here, a little hijinks from teammates, giving a little ribbing, and good nature fun right there. The Twins walk off and win the game 5-4. How's that for a comeback? I thought we were toast, but we go ahead and win it. So we've got the first game in the Cleveland series. How does the rest of the series go? Well, we dropped two in a row. So we lose the series, but we're 7-5 overall. About to take to the road and go to Kansas City for our next games. We're going to come back for more Twins baseball very soon. Hope you'll join me. See you then. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!